was a great Leafs win. I said that was a great Leafs win.
Yeah, and I said,
You're waiting on the Labushka news, aren't you?
Don't act like you're not.
Let's go!
Good. We all feel
Stop!
Good.
Never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Into my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple yeet!
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Good impression, by the way. He's gone.
Leafs win 3-2 over the darn. I really liked how I said Leafs won there too. Let me try it again. It's okay. Leafs win 4-2 over the Arizona Coyotes. That was better.
It wasn't. You never get a do-over when it's perfect.
Boy, is there stuff happening. But real quick, before we start, the Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup is back. This is its 8th season empowering Canadian minor hockey teams to make a positive impact in their community. And that's by doing as many good deeds as possible to fill the cup. How do you win the Good Deeds Cup? Record eligible good deeds on TikTok, Instagram, X, or Facebook. Post it using the hashtag GoodDeedsCup and hashtag contest. And remember to tag Chevrolet Canada as well using your team's name. Every eligible good deed that you, your community, or your family submits on behalf of your team adds up to 1 point. And that goes on the scoreboard for the Good Deeds Cup. But what's the point? Why am I doing all this? Well, number one, good deeds are good. And more importantly, you get $100,000 for the registered Canadian charity of your choice. The more points you collect, the better your odds are of winning this year's Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup. Do you want to be crowned this year's Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup champion? Visit ChevroletGoodDeedsCup.ca to learn more. Now, that was a bit of a nail biter. Dude, there were so many stats being thrown around today before the game where I was like, okay, you're making it basically impossible for the Leafs to win this. You know that, right? Number one, they kept talking about the fact that the Leafs haven't beaten the Arizona Coyotes in Toronto in regulation since October 17th, 2002. What happened on October 17th, 2002? Matthew Knies was born. That is a real stat. Ty Domi was in that game. His son is now on the Leafs. Matt Sundin was in that game. He has a statue outside of Scotiabank Arena. Also, Scotiabank Arena was called something else. Shane Doan was in that game for the Coyotes. He's now in the front office of the Toronto Maple Leafs. And the Coyotes also had Daniel Briere, the GM of the Philadelphia Flyers. And Tom Fitzgerald was on the Leafs, the now GM of the New Jersey Devils. It was ridiculously long ago. Now, that I actually think was on the Leafs' side of things. That is the universe saying, okay, the streak ends now. Except the Arizona Coyotes are on a double-digit winless streak, and this is Alex Kerfoot's return to Toronto. He's scoring. You know he's scoring. That means the Leafs are already down 1-0 at puck drop. So how'd it go? Well, after a pretty quiet start to the game, both teams skating back and forth, a lot of cardio going on, but not a whole lot of shots, Mitch Marner gets a breakaway. And Mitch Marner did what he always does on a breakaway. He passed it. And it worked again! Dude, he's done that in junior. He's done it with the Leafs. Didn't he score a goal with David Kampf? He drops it back for Matthew Knies, who taps it in against his childhood team. His 11th of the season for the rookie, and Mitch's 50th assist of the season, and one of the filthiest 1-0 Leafs after one. Obviously, Mark Giordano got hurt. We will talk about that later because it's significant. Now, we didn't have to wait nearly as long to get the party started in the second period. Wild Bill William Lagesson has the puck way back, fires it on, and for a brief second, I thought he finally had his first career NHL goal. But it was Tyler Bertuzzi again with the tip in, his 12th of the season, goals in three straight. He's doubled his goal total in like, what, 2 weeks? And you see it in the celly. Like, this isn't just a regular season game on a Thursday night. This means something to him. He's building. He feels the Hulkamania. I mean, as much enthusiasm as he's willing to show you. A few weeks ago, I was suggesting that he go out into the parking lot and burn all of his hockey sticks, which is not good for the environment, and also sticks are made of fiberglass these days and it's dangerous. But he obviously did it! That's just a 1:05 into the second period and the Leafs are up 2-0. Late into the second period again, it's a 2-on-1 with Matthew Knies and William Nylander. Knies has the puck, he tries to get it across to Nylander, it's interrupted but still gets to Willie, and you know for a brief second the Coyotes are like, all right, great, we broke it up. Imagine breaking up a 2-on-1 and then the third guy comes in and it's Austin Matthews. That was the most casual, just disrespectful goal. He just strolls in, one leg, rip. His 53rd goal of the season because he's a mutant. And William Nylander also gets his 50th assist, just like Mitch did the period before, and the Leafs are up 3-0. This one's gonna be easy. Dude, I didn't even mention that Joseph Woll made his return in this game, and he looked pretty good, I must say. But it's gonna be an easy night for him, it's gonna be an easy night for the Leafs, except is that Mitch playing defense? Yeah, Mitch Marner was legit playing, like he wasn't, like I'm not saying back-checking, like he was paired with TJ Brody. He was sitting on the defense end of the bench. It was a thing. So yeah, the Leafs did that in the preseason. They also did it in a game earlier this season, but they were up real big in that game, as I recall. And you might be like, Steve, they're up 3-0. That's big. First of all, have you watched the Leafs ever once? Second of all, they're not up 3-0. They're up 3-1. Because look, there he goes right there. There he goes right there. He scored! You and your big mouth, he scored! Morgan Rielly on the power play with a terrible read, and Kerfoot gets a breakaway and buries it. I really didn't think Woll was going to get beaten in this game, and there he goes! There he goes! So now the Leafs only have a 2-goal lead, and Mark Giordano is out. So here's what the Leafs are contending with. Benoit, McCabe have been playing really well together. Pretty sure at least one of those guys is banged up, and in an ideal world where you had ideal cap room and ideal depth, one of them would probably be sitting. I'm hazarding a guess on McCabe. I could be wrong. It could be both. They've also got Brody on the left and Liljegren on the right. They were playing really good together. Well, Liljegren's hurt, so he's not playing in this game. And then you got Rielly and Brody together. This time they swapped. Brody is on the right and Rielly is on the left because the aforementioned Liljegren is hurt. But it's okay, they just got Mark Giordano back and now he's hurt. Dude, I don't know if you were at the game. I had cousins who were sitting right in the corner where he got injured and it was bad. But on the broadcast, I'm not a doctor, man, the lights go out for a sec. He goes down trying to score a goal and he slams into the boards and it looked like the back of his head went first. Sheldon Keefe even said it's a head injury after the game. Like, I'm pretty sure they don't usually give you that information. The Leafs have a real tough cap situation coming up here. They've already said that they're carrying 3 goalies because they don't want to waive Martin Jones. Connor Timmins could be coming back at any moment, and Cali Yarncroke is going to come back at any moment. They just reactivated Joseph Woll. They've already had to send down Marshall Rafai. They've had to send down Max Lajoie. It's a pickle! Heck, Sheldon Keefe said that they considered playing Marner on the right on D before the game started. They were thinking about it with 6 healthy defensemen. Then when they didn't have 6 healthy defensemen, they had to go, welp. And you know what's funny? He was good. He was good, like he was just straight up good back there. But the offense suffered greatly because they just randomly took an $11 million forward out of the rotation. So at the time I'm shooting this video, it sounds like they're working on a trade and it sounds like it's for Ilya Lyubushkin. And you can get mad at that, but like, they shouldn't have a forward on D, much less an $11 million one. Cause like, yes, he can do it, but you know what he should be doing? His job! You ever get asked to do a job that's not your job at your job? Of course you do, but are you thrilled about it? No, you're like, I can do it. And they get mad at you for not doing a good enough job and you're like, but it's not my job! I think I put in a valiant effort given that it's not my job! Halfway through the third period, Joseph Woll makes a save, but Logan Cooley gets it into the within one! I don't know how many syllables that was right there.
Cooley gets it into the within one!
It really did look like they were gonna get the trifecta. The Coyotes were gonna end this losing streak. Alexander Kerfoot was gonna get a goal in Scotiabank Arena against his former team. And the Leafs losing streak, or at least winless streak in regulation on home ice against the Arizona Coyotes was going to edge closer and closer to a quarter century. But no, that isn't how it went. William Nylander got the empty netter. Phew, the Leafs were hemmed in basically the entire final few minutes of the third period, and they come out with the win. It was a flying by the seat of your pants sort of win, and I think it's a line in the sand sort of win. You need to go out and get someone. Like, there's no ifs, ands, or buts here. You have to make a trade. And it sounds like they're going to, and it sounds like I'm gonna make another video very shortly after this one. Before I get to questions, that Ryan Reeves fight against Liam O'Brien was awesome. O'Brien is a tough customer and has been fighting everyone in the NHL this season, so Good on Reeves. He still got it. His first fight since the second game of the season. Joseph Wool got the belt. We love that Wool got the belt. You know what? We don't have time for questions because it sounds like they're finalizing the trade. But I did want to point this out from Alex Hobson. This is a very good point. Willie Styles with 28 points in 22 games since the extension. Hashtag committed. Hashtag team guy. It looks like that mini slump was just that. A mini slump. So that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it, and click subscribe because there's gonna be more videos. Tell all your friends. Boosh. Maybe?